I'ma be.
Rich baby, what?
I'ma be.
The shit baby, check me out.
I'ma be.
On top, never stop.
I'ma be.
Muy buenas tardes, mi gente. Today is Monday, February 13th, a day before Valentine's Day. I know I had posted last week that I would be posting two episodes over the weekend, but I totally forgot that it was Super Bowl Sunday, so I got kind of caught up, yada, yada, yada. You know how that goes. Like I just mentioned right now, tomorrow's Valentine's Day, guys, so go pick up flowers. I know the street vendors will probably have plenty to choose from. If not, the dollar, the 99, the purple one, they have small little bouquets for about $5, $6. I also posted just now, the Dollar Tree has balloons galore for you guys. So no hay excusa de que you couldn't or you forgot, because I'm reminding you right now. So vayan y agarren sus cosas, do not disappoint. It's Valentine's Day, guys. So quiero empezar con mis saludos. Primeramente quería saludar a mi amigo Mr. Hugo, the vinyl man. Hi. Yes, I did finally use your idea. He had suggested to use the I'ma be as an intro. And there it is. Everybody loved it. So I'm going to go with it, but of course give you the credit because you gave me that idea. I want to give a saludo to the comadre Vero. We go way, way back. Back to kindergarten. Veronica Gonzalez. Hi, comadre. I actually sent her one of the mugs for Christmas. Aquí está. She's just beautiful all the way around. You can follow her on her TikTok, La Brujita something. It's on her screen, so check her out. She has so much stuff to just look at. I want to give another saludo to my mom. Hi, mom. She watches my stuff the other day. I just watched your video. Here I am. And I want to saludar my little nephews too, Julian and Jimmy, because I know they watch my stuff. So hi, boys. I hope you guys are being good today. And I have goodies for you tomorrow. So I will catch you after school. I would love to give a huge thank you to everybody that follows me, is subscribed to me, and is just a pal. Thank you guys from me to you. I appreciate every single hello, every single heart, every single comment, every single thing just means the world to me. On that end, también, let me remind you guys, check in on your loved ones, people. Knock on the door, a text message, a phone call, anything just to say you care. You know, people matter. I know a lot of the times, like me personally, I hate bugging, so it's like, but you know what? You never know, especially when they fall off the radar real quick. It's like you don't want to bug. Obviously, they're going through something, but just a text message with a hi or a cheese emoji, you know, like, you know what I mean? Anything just to, you know, start that conversation, spark it up and see what's going on with them. You never know what people are going through, right? All right, guys. So before I jump into the topic of the day, I want to just disclose that everything I'm talking about here obviously is not mine. I don't own the rights to it. It's courtesy of Wikipedia and Google News and the news. So I just wanted to throw that out there. I don't own the rights to anything. I am just discussing this for debate and entertainment purposes. So on the subject today was the huge balloon, spy balloon, white balloon, air balloon, weather balloon, however you want to refer it to. That was the Chinese balloon that got shot down last week. I took to social media during last week as a heads up of what the whole topic was going to be this week. And it's, you know, the weather balloon. I want to always know what people are thinking. That, like, I gotta know how that chisme rolls, you know? So I asked on my social media, okay, guys, what are your thoughts? What are your opinions? What do you think of this huge balloon that is above us? So this huge balloon, for you, those of you guys that don't know or are unaware of what I was talking about, it was first spotted over Alaska, Canada, lingered over Montana, and came over to the coast of South Carolina, where finally the U.S. Navy shot it down. Okay, during this time, it was a total of 8 days that this balloon was just hanging out. They had the Pentagon go up over the balloon. It was said that they were up 60,000 feet in the air. And this balloon measured 200 feet overall. So the Pentagon studied it. They came to conclusion after scanning it that it had antennas in there of some sort. They weren't sure. But from the conclusion that the Pentagon came to was that it was like smart antennas that were able to pick up different communication phone calls and stuff of that sort. Okay, the first thing that was said was, it's just a weather balloon. Don't worry about it. Okay, it was kind of like, what the heck? Okay, so if it's just a weather balloon, why is it sitting there? Why is our, you know, Navy, military, whatever, armed forces, I should say, why are our armed forces doing anything to shoot this thing down? Like, it's kind of scary, you know, and it's like questionable, like, why would it be up there so long just hanging out? Okay, after a few days, a Chinese spokeswoman did say it was a firing practice of some sort, a flight, and that somehow it got out of, you know, direction, and it just floated away. It just left. Okay, which is it? A test flight? Was it a spy balloon? Was it a weather balloon? Like, what was it, right? Well, once again, I took to social media, like I said, and I asked everybody's opinions, okay? This is what everybody had to say. What was it? I guess we won't know. But like I did say, the Pentagon did assure that it had the ability to pick up signals of intelligence. So what we did, I guess, what was done, not we, like personally me, but like, you know, the Navy in this situation, they waited till this balloon got out to the coast so they can shoot it down because they weren't sure what was in there. They didn't know if it had explosives. They didn't know. There's videos of that. I also seen a comment, as you guys saw, that said that I guess the government was issuing reward money for anybody that picked up pieces to this balloon that they shot down. So, truth or not, I don't know. I didn't try to look that up because I believe what was said. But yeah, it was a big desmadre up in the sky, you know? So this just broke into pieces, obviously, once it got shot. There's a bunch of trash going everywhere, yada, 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 and it is what it is, okay? So now the question still continues from everybody. Why was this weather balloon up there? Why did the Chinese send it this way? Because once again, if they say that supposedly it just drifted away, how can you not catch it? It takes weeks to get here. You know, like, yeah, no. I don't know. Like I said, I don't know. I wanted to know what you guys thought. And I got really good answers. So thank you guys for all your input. I appreciate it. You know, we were here to debate and share opinions. And that's what we did. A couple days after we first spotted the first balloon, Latin America also reported that there was a huge balloon rolling over Costa Rica. They were the ones that made a report. So yeah, it's like, okay, how many weather balloons do you guys have? How many test flights do you guys have that you just let wander off, you know? There was also a follow-up since, you know, the original debate video I put up. They've seen, I believe, one or two more over Alaska balloons. And they've also shot down unidentified objects. I guess the term would be a UFO because they're unidentified. But when I posted that on my social media, it's not necessarily like extraterrestrials. They're not coming to invade. ET ain't coming home. Like, these things are really unidentified. The government doesn't know. Like, our armed forces are like tripping because they don't know what it is. They're thinking maybe it's some kind of missile coming from out there as well. So yeah, all of the US right now is in high alert because of these things. They've shot down a couple. Here's one of the articles. So yeah, it's kind of it's questionable. Why are these things here? Especially when they have this whole, like, they're intelligent too. So that's what's happening in our skies right now. Like I said, I was just curious to know what everybody's thinking. Should we be concerned? Should we be scared? Are you scared? Are you worried? You know, déjenme un comment below. Because you guys know, a mí la comadrebee me encanta oír de ustedes. So tell me what you guys think. And like I said, let's see where all these sightings and stories lead to, you know, because it's like, spies. Yeah, going on to the whole spy thing, I'm sitting here thinking like, man, like, spies really do exist. Like, they really want to know what we're up to, so they're sending this. Okay, way back when we used actual people, they're obviously still around. And I'm not talking about Angelina Jolie in the movie Salt or the Austin Powers movie. Like, we're talking serious stuff, you know? So I started, like, thinking, huh, I wonder who was, like, the first known spy. And then I was like, huh, I wonder who was the first female spy. Like, I just want to know, you know? It's like so much of everything that there is everywhere documented, and we don't know because we just don't know. So I found two people of my interest. One was a male, one was a female. So, vámonos y dejo y les cuento lo ocurrido. The first spy I looked up was the man, and he was known as Thomas Knowlton. He was big back in 1740 with the George Washington times. So, just to give you guys a time frame of when and how far he goes. So this man served in the French and Indian War, and he was also a colonel during the American Revolution. So yeah, this guy had a bunch of war history under his belt, right? This man's known to be America's very first professional source of intelligence. What does that mean? It means he was the first spy. That's what that means. He had a whole army of men, and they were known as Knowlton's Rangers. So what his little army were known for, not only attacking, fighting, this and that, they were known for gathering all intelligence information that they can gather during this time of war. And this was the actual American Revolution. So that's the part where he and his troops became known as spies. Well, this man ran a few missions, because that's what they're referred to. And he was later killed at the Battle of Harlem Heights. So that's when he died. But during the entire time he was, you know, in service, he was doing the thing. So this guy was born back in November 22nd of 1740. And yeah, his whole family was military background. He was born in the state of Massachusetts in a small town called West Boxford. A few years after, when he turned 8, the dad decided to move the whole family away. They ended up in Ashford, Connecticut, so that's where they pretty much made home. At the age of 15, he enrolled into the military and was real excited that he was able to fight the enemy with his brother Daniel. He did a total of 6 campaigns, which are missions. A couple years later, in 1760, he was promoted to lieutenant. This man also fought back in 1762, the British expedition against Cuba. So he has a lot of very known missions that he was in, battles, whatever you want to know. Ahí andaba, just doing the damn thing, right? So yeah, era chingón el señor. Later on, when he was done with the whole Cuba battle, he went back home and he ended up getting married to a woman by the name of Anna Keys. They raised 9 kids together. They were in Connecticut, you know, living the whole life. At the age of 33, this man was appointed by this whole city a select man. So that is the word for local government board member. A couple years later, in 1775, General Thomas Gage dispatched a bunch of British troops to come and start a war, again, over Lexington and Concord in Massachusetts. The whole community, the militias, got all their people together. Otro desmadre en medio. It was just boom, boom, back and forth. You know how that goes. At this time, Knowlton was anonymously voted to be captain. He had 200 men in his force, and this was mainly composed by farmers and just civilians. They weren't even like trained soldiers or anything. If you had a gun, vámonos, let's go. That's how he seen it. We gotta go, we gotta do this. The following year, George Washington, he was just a general of army. He wasn't a president yet. He chose this man, Mr. Knowlton, to be a colonel lieutenant. So he gave him the right to select a bunch of men, you know, a big group of men from Connecticut, Rhode Island, and Massachusetts to carry out and just bust these missions. Like, hey, you need your men. You have my permission. Go round these people up. Vámonos. And that's how he got the name to his, you know, group here, the Knowlton Rangers. They're the ones that became the spies. That's how all that started. They were known as the first organized American elite troops. Okay, so now we're gonna go to September of 1776. Knowlton's crew was all involved in that battle I told you about, which is Harlem Heights. This is where he gets shot. Okay, so they go here to do this mission because we have enemies here, right? So sitting here in this battle, they were fighting the British. They were successful. Then they ended up doing a counterattack. So what does that mean? They went back for more. They ended up winning this counterattack. They had a very known rifleman with them out of the state of Virginia by the name of Andrew Litch. Well, when all this was going down, General Washington gave them all, like, you know, a whole play-by-play of how to ambush them and, you know, take them all out. Well, it backfired because they didn't really make the operation the way they should have. They ended up getting the attention of the British Army beforehand, so they ended up getting shot instead. And this is where Mr. Knowlton got shot, and he died right here at this battle by an operation that didn't go as planned. So we're gonna fast forward it to 1995, right? And now the Military Intelligence Corp Association decided to get this award going for all the soldiers that have died on the line of duty. It's known as the Thomas Knowlton award. It's mainly for spy soldiers, not just soldiers in general. It's the ones that have the whole, you know, intelligent background, and they're doing all these sneaky things and finding all this stuff out for us, the people. Serve the MI Corp with distinction. So they have to be super disciplined and good people, in other words. So that was information on this guy. I hope it was new to you guys, because it definitely was to me. I had no idea when all this spy stuff started or anything, but now you know, goes back to the 1700s. And like I said, I hope I showed you something new. That's what I'm here for. And then next I'm gonna go over to a woman spy. She was very known. And it's crazy because there is so much like controversy behind her. Because some people say she never existed. Other people say she did and died while giving birth. It's just a whole lot of I don't know what. And I don't know what to believe. But the story is really fun. So I'm going to give it to you. And like I said, drop a comment. Tell me. Let me know what you guys think. Or maybe you know other stuff. And we'll go from there. So this lady had no name. She was known as Numbers. She was Spy 355. Yeah, no name, just 355. Agent 355. So she was a spy for the Continentals going back to the War of the American Independence. Yeah, she goes that far back. I mean, the 1700s, I believe. So here's where everything starts getting, huh, what the heck? So 355 is actually a code that they, the intelligent people, use to describe us, meaning female, a woman spy. And she was part of the Culper Ring, which is a network of spies that were, you know, doing their thing in that time frame, that era. So she is the first registered spy, female spy for the United States. And once again, like I said, her identity was never even revealed. They never even knew who she really was. They didn't know a name for her. They just know she was there. So I wasn't even able to get a picture of her, like nothing. She's just 355. That's it. George Washington's involved in this one too. I'm gonna tell you how. Okay, the only proof that this woman, 355, ever existed was on a letter. So the years was 1778 to 1780. It wasn't a long time she was there. There was a letter written by a man named Abraham Woodhull to George Washington, and he was talking about Agent 355. So he was telling Mr. Washington, he was describing her, that he was giving her all the credit to being of a lot of service to this correspondence. Like I said, this is literally the only evidence that this 355 ever existed. Name unknown. Who knows? They do know that she worked with the American Patriots during the Revolutionary War, and she was a spy. So that is super well known. They think that likely she was recruited by this Woodhull to be, you know, involved in this ring of spies. So I guess he pulled her in. I don't know how they come to this conclusion, but that is the thought behind how she got involved. So the way the code for her name 355 is, it shows, I guess, that she had some kind of background with intelligence before becoming an official spy with some degree of social prominence. That's what it said. I'm not sure what they think, but from what I got, yeah, they think she already had a background. She was known to actually live in New York City. And that she had good contact with Major John Andre and Benedict Arnold. I don't know how they know this, but they say that they were friends. So then now here comes the people saying that no, it's a lie. They're saying once again that Agent 355 was never even real. That it was just information that they would gather from random women, like females that carried information, so that I guess it goes, you know, down on record. Oh, you know, we spoke with 355. So yeah, necessarily doesn't mean that the woman was a real woman that was in the ring of spies with them. Like I said, it's just controversy because some people dicen que sí, otros dicen que no. At the end of the day, quién sabe? We weren't there. So, who knows? Did she exist? Did she not? Do you guys know anything about 355? Let me know. They say también, dicen las malas lenguas, not me, que she was part of the British, like, family. Like, somewhere, somehow, she was British. So, is this true? Is it not? Is that how she was able to get intel? Who knows? But they do say and give her credit that she was behind getting Andre and Arnold caught. So they captured them and they hung them. So she does take all the credit for that. They give it to her. They say she was the one that busted them. So like I said, this again, who knows? These two men got, they hung them in Topan, New York. That's why it was so easy for her to set it up, because I guess era raza de ellos, so they believed her, they trust her. I don't know. Like I said, I'm only going on what I read. Who knows the true story? Like I said, was there even really a 355? Another story also says that 355 got busted by Arnold Benedict and was arrested and sent over to a prison ship where supposedly she was pregnant and gave birth to a son. Her little boy was named Robert Townsend Jr. And this story has it that supposedly she died a little bit right after. Not necessarily giving birth. It doesn't really say if or what, but it said she died on this prison ship. Once again, truth or not, I don't know. There is so many stories that go on with Miss 355. Who knows? There's also another story that says that supposedly 355 was never even an agent. Her husband was the prisoner in this prison ship, and that she would come aboard the ship just to feed him and see him, visit, you know, take care of her viejo because he was busted. They do have a name, which is Anna Strong. So maybe this is true now. Maybe they're onto something since they do have an actual name. The husband that was supposedly imprisoned in this ship was named Sila Strong. So yeah, now they're saying maybe because she was seen there often, they thought she was a spy. I don't know. You decide. You come to your conclusion and let me know. So that is what I have for you guys today. I hope it was of interest, because I took you guys back to history 101. And well, like I said, mañana es otro día. I will give you the other video I said. Y pues ahí a ver qué. Hopefully you guys all have a beautiful Valentine's Day. Remember, it ain't just about sweethearts. Es el día del amor y la amistad. So if you have a friend, send them a text. You have a girlfriend, like, you know, a girlfriend, tell her you love her. All your pals, you know what I mean? Just, oh my God, we're so in love. Like, come on, stop being so cliche. Even though it's a nice holiday, don't take me wrong. You know, I get it. I'm 1-4 Valentine's Day, so I already have my evening planned out for tomorrow. Follow me, guys, on Instagram, Facebook, TikTok, Pinterest, and of course, here on YouTube. Like, subscribe, and hit the pinche campanita, guys. Thank you guys so much, and like always, stay safe, stay sane, y ahí los miro al rato. Los adoro. Bye.